Hello, party people. Welcome to the new game of the day. This one is going to be a pitch game. We will see the pitch defense. It's another, I would say, tactical opening. We will see a very beautiful king attack. And you will see some basic patterns, I would say, basic attack patterns, not only for the pH but also for the King's Indian. And you will see some things that I would say that are characteristic for the pH. This is one of the reasons why I choose this game. This one is Zinn with white playing against Fuchs with black. Zinn was a very, I guess, good German tactician. And this game was played in Berlin in 1964. Okay, let's look at the game. We see the typical pitch, e4 and g6, d4, usual standard moves. You can play bishop to e3, it's nothing unusual. I guess my mainline would have been f3 or c3. But again, it's a completely okay move. And here we see one signature move of the pH defense. White plays his knight to c3. The idea is that he wants to castle long so that he doesn't want to move this pawns. And he wants to protect his e-pawn. But the main idea is just to keep these pawns here so that white can castle long. So we see knight to f6 and we see f2, f3. This is a standard move and a standard idea. White wants to play queen to d2 and then exchanging strong bishop on g7. And to overprotect e4, he plays f3. So you reinforce your pawn here. And black castles, and as I said, white plays queen to e2, and we see rook to e8. White castles long. Again, like in the Sicilian Needy defense games, we see here castling on opposite sides, so that you will have a pawn storm, you will have a lot of tactical ideas and games. If you don't like that, if you don't want those kind of games, then I would recommend that you castle short. But black plays c6, white plays h4, he's attacking immediately on the king side. And this is another standard idea. You basically want to push this pawn and open up the h-file, so that if you, when you play bishop to h6, you can exchange, and then you play your queen to h6, so that you have this open file here, and then you basically attack h7. White plays b5, and this is a good move. In this kind of positions, you need counterplay, no matter what, because otherwise you will just lose, because these pawns, if you do nothing, they just come at you. So he plays b4. b5 is the idea of playing b4 and getting the queen out. You have this basically a pawn storm on the other side. And this is just the idea of, or you have to see which attack will be faster. Because, okay, now here white plays another standard move. He plays h5. As I said, he wants to open up to the g line, and black plays queen to a5. You can play knight to h5. You can play this move. The problem is that then white plays this move here, and this move is tricky. I'm always glad if I can sack my exchange here and play a rook to h5, because now you have an automatic attack against the king side. This king is a little bit open. Yeah, you have all the lines here, and this pawn will fall, and then you will have an open h line. So if black does not manage to get any counterplay, then this will be very, very hard for him. But right now, this position is right about equal. Now, white would play basically all his pieces to the king side, right? And black would try to defend. You would get something like this. You hold on to h5, and at the same time, you get another piece in the defense. I'm just showing you some basic attacking ideas here in this kind of position, because this can also arise after king after the king's Indians in the defense. You will see this idea very, very often. Yeah? H5, knight to h5, and then the sack on h5. And you should know how to attack and how to defend here. Basically, the ideas for both sides are very easy. Get all the pieces to the king. If you attack, get all the pieces to the king, and if you defend, get all the pieces to your king. I'm just showing you some basic lines here, ideas that can arise. And this position is equal. It's not winning or losing this sack, but it's an interesting sacrifice. I would play it against a weaker player. Not against a stronger player, but against a weaker player, I would play it. So black didn't want to have any of it, so he played his queen to a5. Okay, white exchange. Black took back on g6 with that pawn. And engines don't like this kind of positions for black, but this is still playable. This is not lost. Basically, there is some kind of equilibrium in this position. Okay, we see the standard idea with bishop h6. Black rightfully here black played bishop to h8. This, if you see this for the first time, you say what's going on, but this is the right idea, because you don't want to exchange here and get the king, the queen here. And if you play bishop to h8, basically this h line is closed. And white has to look for some other avenues for his attack. And here he played e5, because he wants to open up the position. And black played the right move he played before. He needs counterplay. He has to open here. He has to find some avenues to attack here. And white goes back. He goes with his knight to b1. He cannot take here, because then black just takes back and is harassing here the queen, so he has to go back. Okay, he captures on e5, and white plays check. He plays bishop to c4. Still, the position is equal. It looks kind of scary for black, but it holds. Black plays knight to d5. Here, white captures on e5. And black develops. He calmly develops. He plays his other knight to d7, and we see f4 by white. It's not the best move, but okay. And this is an interesting position, because if you can hold this position, or let's say I put it another way, if you have survived as black so far, then you can pretty much be sure that you have equalized. Okay, because white can't really get any better out of the opening, and now your pieces are undeveloped. And again, this is, it looks, at the first glance, it looks horrible for black, but this is still holding. Okay, so the pH is not that bad as the engine makes it look. White here plays b3, bishop b3. He wants to maintain his bishop. And black plays bishop to g4. White plays f3, knight f3. And e6, and this is believe it or not, this is equal. You have this beautiful knight here that cannot be really scared away. Let's put it this way: here's everything safe. The queen attack is going nowhere, and you have this bad piece here. So it's not bad. Black can be very satisfied. Now he captures, And here he played rook to d8. A better idea would have been to play c5, so that you have the threat of c4. And in this kind of position, yeah, I mean, it's equal, but you always, as black, you have to look for counterplay. This is the problem with those double-edged positions. At the end of the day, you cannot really make, weak moves, and you always have to look for counterplay. And rook d8, nothing really, that's really nothing for counterplay. And the problem is, or the immediate tactic problem is that now white plays bishop g5, and this is very strong, because you open up the h line. Now that white can play queen to h2, and you open it with a tempo. Yeah, so you cannot really defend. Let's say that black would have played black plays c5 here. And now bishop to g5. You could easily have played a move like bishop to g7. And even if you lose h7, pawn on h7, you will not get checkmated on h8. You don't have to play, you don't even have to play bishop to g7, you can play just simply c5 here. It's funny to see how this one move really basically destroyed black. Okay, now again this comes to the tempo, and now you see the idea. He plays queen to h2. Sin, and this is a big problem now, because now you have this automatic attack here on h7, and this bishop here doesn't defend h8, so you have a problem. Black plays queen to c5, and white plays rook to h1, and now you have this battery against h7. He thought that after queen to e3, check, he would have some counterplay, because after this move, after knight to d2, he played h5, and he thought, okay, what is going to happen? How is white strengthening the attack? And he just sacrifices. He plays rook to h5, and this is strong now, because after taking on h5, you can play. You can take here on h5, and now again you have this double attack. White is working with double attacks, and this is why black here loses. He loses too many tempos, because he has to go with this. He has to defend against this attacks, and he thought that after taking here with the queen, that he would have something. Because white cannot take. If he takes and he plays king to d2, then you would have this double attack, this fork, and you would pick up the queen and winning. But white here just calmly played king to b1. And now what do you do? There's no way of saving this rook and at the same time saving h8. So you will have to do something, and you lose the h8 bishop, and this is completely lost now, because this attack is lethal, because after this move it's clear that black will never be able to get on the queen side, where he may survive, but he will get in a mating net here. He plays basically the only moves here. Black's he plays king to g8, and white here played f5, attacking also the king, but he could have also played queen to h8. Basically, any king, any queen move, and any queen check here wins. Here, black tried queen to g2, but white just took, and here black resigned. This is completely hopeless for black. A better move for white would have been to play, queen to h8, but again I thought this was time travel or something, This is winning and even quicker, because you will lose the house and you will lose this rook here and this rook and yeah. I mean, this was a great attacking game. You should really study it, because you may think, hey, Black is busted, but he's not busted. And but if White manages to somehow get through on the king side, then it's basically almost lethal. Yeah, you can sack here the whole rook. And since you have this double attack here on the rook and on this field here, it's hopeless. And yeah. I hope you enjoyed the game. I hope you enjoyed this Pirch game. I mean, you saw some basic ideas. You saw that this kind of structure is survivable, even if the engine says that it's bad. Yeah, so thank you. Bye-bye.